Hey ladies, and welcome back to IRL Jax, where I share with you my real life as it happens. And today we're continuing our PCOS series, where I talk about diet, exercise, diagnosis, management, and getting pregnant with PCOS. Today's segment is going to be talking about management and possible medications used to treat your PCOS. If you've been watching my other videos, you know that managing PCOS has a lot to do with managing insulin resistance and blood sugar. So if you haven't checked out the diet and exercise videos, now is a great time to do that because that's a huge part of managing PCOS. Getting your weight down to a normal BMI level and having a maintainable diet that doesn't spike your blood sugar is incredibly important and a huge part of dealing with PCOS. Now, there are some medications that can help you along the way. One of the most common things prescribed for PCOS is metformin, which is actually a diabetes medication. It works by increasing the sensitivity of the cells to the insulin and sugar that is coming to them, which is perfect because that's exactly the opposite of what insulin resistance is. Insulin resistance is when your cells don't respond very well to your natural insulin, and so making them more sensitive is exactly what we want to do. Your OBGYN or your primary care doctor may be the ones prescribing this, and they should only prescribe metformin if your blood sugar levels are high consistently. If they try to put you on metformin just to get you to ovulate or cycle normally, be cautioned that that is an old way of thinking, and new science in 2017, 2018 has proven that that's not really as effective as we once thought it was for fixing the reproductive side of PCOS. While metformin is used all the time to treat women with PCOS, it's not its on-label use. And you'll hear the phrase off-label use when you talk to your doctor about metformin. All that means is that this drug hasn't gone through a bunch of testing specifically related to PCOS. It has gone through a bunch of testing specifically for diabetes. Because we know how closely related diabetes and insulin resistance is, doctors feel very comfortable prescribing metformin. The most common side effect when you take metformin is tummy troubles, and considering people with PCOS already have a high tendency towards IBS symptoms, it can really double down on an area that is already hard to manage in your life. Extended release versions of the drug are much, much, much gentler on your stomach, and you should definitely ask your doctor about getting that version prescribed if you have to go on metformin. That being said, some people decide that it is just not worth it to have the extra tummy troubles when going on metformin, and instead decide to manage their diet more closely to help with their blood sugar regulation. Another great medical option to manage your PCOS is birth control. Birth controls with an anti-testosterone agent can really help bring down some of the other icky side effects of PCOS, like weight gain and excessive hair growth. This is because women with PCOS tend to have higher levels of testosterone. That's one of the things you'll get tested for when you go to talk to your doctor about whether or not you have PCOS. I talk more about that in the very first video in this series. The other upsides of taking birth control, besides just getting your testosterone down, are the fact that they will give you regular cycles. And I talked about in a different video how one of the long-term effects of PCOS is the increased risk of endometrial cancer because you don't cycle. Obviously, birth controls force you to cycle, force you to shed that lining, getting rid of that risk of a higher chance for endometrial cancer. In extreme cases where women have become obese because of PCOS, weight loss drugs may be prescribed, but that only occurs in very rare cases, and most of the time, a solid combination of managing your blood sugar, a healthy diet, and increasing your exercise are enough to decrease the effect of excess weight gain with PCOS. Over-the-counter supplements are another big area that gets talked about with PCOS. Now, I have dug into this a ton, and what I found is less is more. I will link a podcast where a wonderful doctor talks about some of the side effects and worries with taking too many supplements, and even some of the very common ones that are recommended with PCOS. That being said, there are a few that doctors do recommend pretty universally that you take. The first is a good prenatal vitamin. Every woman of childbearing age is recommended to be on a good prenatal vitamin. I highly recommend you choose one that's easy to digest and also has folate in it instead of folic acid, as some people don't absorb folic acid very well. The next one is a vitamin D supplement. Most of America is pretty deficient in vitamin D, and I get tested for my vitamin D levels pretty regularly by different doctors, and it always comes up short if I'm not taking my vitamin D supplements. Consult your doctor to know which dosage of vitamin D you should be on. The other supplements that I recommend aren't necessarily related strictly to PCOS, but more to IBS symptoms, which are very common in women with PCOS. And so getting a good digestive enzyme and a good refrigerated probiotic can really help with your tummy troubles and help your digestive system just be one less thing you have to worry about in your battle with PCOS. When treating PCOS, a lot of women turn to alternative medicines instead of some of the more harsh traditional Western medicine techniques to try to treat their symptoms and come up with a long-term solution. Acupuncture, essential oils, and traditional Chinese medicine are the top three that I've come across. While there's not as many studies to confirm or deny the effects of any of these, it's definitely worth checking out if it's something that piques your interest. My only caution is that since these areas aren't regulated by any government entity, that you do your due diligence to make sure the person you're talking to is well-trained and well-educated in these areas and isn't someone that just got a certificate online or decided to sell essential oils on the side to make some money. The last thing that you need to be aware of is your mental health. When managing PCOS, it can really become overwhelming at times, especially if you end up getting an infertility diagnosis as well. I highly recommend getting a counselor as soon as you experience any signs of stress or depression related to your PCOS. It's a lifelong battle, and you need the tools to deal with it mentally as much as you do the tools to deal with it physically. When it comes to the infertility side of PCOS, there's a whole other list of drugs to use to treat that, and I'm gonna save those for my next video where I talk about getting pregnant with PCOS. If you found this video helpful and you'd like me to continue making videos, make sure to hit that like button and that subscribe button. And of course, as always, keep on fighting, ladies!